We're here today talking about Cottontales TV, which is a rabbit hunting show that encompasses friendships and rabbit hunting and beagles and laughter and a lot of fun all wrapped into one.
One shot, took him out.
Hey, Fletch, did you see the rabbit?
That's how it's done right there. Good job, boys.
All right.
On to the next one. Getting into rabbits is there's nothing like it. You know it's gonna be a good day, you know, when you drop the tailgates and the dogs start howling and they start getting into it. And it just makes you wanna get out there and work hard with them.
Here we go, here we go. All right, here we go.
Come on.
Hike to them in here now.
It's the time you get to spend with your animals, with your friends, with my family. It's the enjoyment of getting out there and having a good time. At the end of the day, I mean, everybody wants to have fun. This is one way that we love to do it. We hope to see a lot of action and high intensity.
Where's that rabbit at? Where's the rabbit?
Seeing the dogs, you know, work the trail. And you're gonna see the hunters communicating with each other and how to try to outsmart the rabbits.
Come on, yeah.
But you know, how to communicate with the dogs and work with them in unison to, again, harvest that rabbit. One of the most fun things about rabbit hunting is that anybody can rabbit hunt. Everybody's out there and doing different things, and everybody hunts a little bit different.
The track's getting hotter and hotter, the scent's getting better.
And there's a lot of tricks, you know, that it takes time to develop and for people to learn.
Get him up!
And I think that's something to show and encompass in the show is safety and ethical hunting and the right way to go about it.
They're on a track, they'll bump until they actually get the rabbit moving, and then it'll be a hot track.
Looks like the rabbit probably stopped or turned right in there somewhere.
Typically the rabbits will run in somewhat of a circle or an oval. So we're gonna see what the dogs do here for a few minutes, and they can get back on it and turn it this way, then we'll spread out and hopefully get the first kill of the day.
Hopefully that rabbit will make a loop and come out in the hardwoods, we'll have a nice, easy shot. Easy being the operative word.
Come on, gang. Where's the gang?
Find him.
That's it. Hike on in here. Some good-looking stuff.
I mean, that's what we look for essentially is, call it rabbitat or the rabbit habitat. So when we look for a place, we want that, you know, that filthy looking stuff that you don't want to walk through, because essentially that's where they're going to be hiding. Hey, Fletch, did you see the rabbit?
That's a shame, man. They were really on that one hot. What happened, gang? John, when I stepped in this stuff, and boom, that thing just screaming out of there.
That was a hot chase. I saw that rabbit. It was a hot chase. It really was.
Hey, rabbit.
Whoop!
Hey, rabbit.
You don't need a lot to rabbit hunt other than rabbits. But there are a lot of things that can make it easier too. And over 15 years of doing this, we've learned, you know, having our Tritronic collars, you know, for those teachable moments with the dogs, and our Garmin satellite system to know exactly where the dogs are and what they're doing. Our wildlife management system, down to the shells and the shotguns we use, you know, we've fine-tuned this over many years. And without those tools, we could still do this and have a lot of fun, but it sure does make it precise and sure does improve the quality.
Rabbit come bouncing it right there. It just stopped and set. One shot, took him out. He came out right through here. Came and just set right there.
For us, it's not about the score at the end of the day. It's not about the quantity. It's all about the quality. It's about the experiences we have out there, the fun, the stories that we tell at the end of the day. And it's what we spend 5 months out of the year doing here in Virginia. And it's what we'll continue to do until we can't.